signal over to him.
Hey, if I was you, I'd listen to Jericho.
If I was you, I'd keep my mouth shut.
I think it's best that Johnny Stamboli just mind his own business.
Yeah, he needs to just keep his own little personal world and stop messing with a 7-foot, 500-pound giant.
Well, now Raven and Stamboli talking a little trash before this matchup gets underway, but real quick, we got to send out our best wishes to Bradshaw, who unfortunately this past Monday night on Raw tore his bicep. And unfortunately for Bradshaw and all of us here in the WWE, Bradshaw's going to be out 4 to 6 months.
See, you know what that means, Coach. There's no golfing between you and Bradshaw in the next 4 to 6 months.
The Bradshaw Coach World Tour has certainly been slowed down, but I did talk to him on Friday, and he told me that luckily it's his left bicep, so he's still able to drink beer.
Oh, and that's all that matters. You know, it's all good then.
As long as he can still drink beer, Bradshaw's cool. So I know he's watching tonight, and we're sending our best out to you, buddy, and drink a cold one for us.
And I guarantee you, as soon as that bicep heals, he'll be right back on the tail of the Un-American as soon as he gets back here.
You're damn right. Well, now Stamboli is taking it to Raven, and I'm not so sure Raven thought that Stamboli was capable of this.
You know, I'm not a fan of either of these guys, but once again, I find myself rooting for Raven to go down. Let's go, Stamboli, let's go!
Well, speaking of rooting, were you rooting for Jamal and Rose to show up on SmackDown this past Thursday? That footage we saw a few minutes ago was unbelievable
to me. That was off the charts, and, you know, Eric Bischoff is proving he's a master of disguise. I didn't know it was him. No one knew it was him. And when he said 3 minutes in that distinctive voice,
it didn't matter
what face you were looking at, you knew.
Oh.
Wow. Look at that. The one thing about Raven is his offense, especially that knee lift, can come out of anywhere. He can hit it from any point in the mat. That's what makes him so dangerous.
You know, right after this, right after we're done with heat tonight, oh, wait a second.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Raven, the whiplash into the bottom rope. And you can see what that has done to Johnny Stamboli and Raven right back on top. Well, you know, we got to catch the red eye tonight to get out to Denver, Colorado.
You're damn right.
And you got to believe that Eric Bischoff was already there, probably sitting around in a bar somewhere, reveling, telling everybody the tremendous story and the fact that he ruined the season premiere of SmackDown. Here's a cover two. Ruined the season premiere of SmackDown on Thursday.
Coach, he also could be sitting there planning his next offensive move, his next shot across the bow. You just don't know what's going on in that man's mind. He is a genius, and it's scary what he's planning on doing or could plan on doing to make Raw the number one show.
Well, it was certainly something I never expected, and I don't think anybody expected on Thursday. One out, Raven and Stamboli. Very evenly matched, I might add, here in this matchup. And Stamboli taking offense to the fact that Raven has not paid him for taking you on a few weeks ago.
Yeah, you know, see, a drop toe through the ropes. I felt that one before. Not only is Raven an idiot, apparently he's a cheapskate too.
If you're going to hire somebody to do a job, at least pay him.
Yeah, you know, you got to pay him off.
You know, Raven is still yet to pay me for carrying him on heat for like 4 months.
Well, he did pay you. He did pay you. He left.
Well, that was better than money.
That's payment enough, Coach. Yeah, come on now.
You cannot put a price on that, that's for sure. Well, now Raven sliding back in the ring, and you can see Johnny Stamboli ringside here certainly feeling the effects. And Raven, you know, I'll give credit where credit's due. I mean, he's tremendous in the ring, and he knows how to pick apart an opponent.
Coach, I will give the devil his due. Raven can flat out wrestle, and with moves like that,
will that be enough right on that left shoulder? No. Stamboli kicks out.
He can flat out wrestle. This kid can go. Raven is one of the best in this company. Yet, his attitude.
Ask him. He'll tell you.
He'll tell you a thousand times.
Uh-oh. Catching Raven. Nice belly to belly. And down goes Raven. But now Stamboli attempting to get back up.
What brings him down is his attitude. It's definitely his attitude, and that's what brings him down, and that's what makes him, in my opinion, a loser, and that's why I keep inducting his ass in the Sky High Hall of Fame.
Well, you bring up a good point. I'm so marveled every week at how nice the back of our heads are. You know, our barbers are tremendous.
Well, you know, clean shave is the best, you know.
Well, you know, that's what the ladies like. At least that's what they tell me.
Well, hey.
Oh, and now, where the sun don't even think about shining.
Spin kick. What athleticism by Stamboli.
Oh, but Raven is right back up to his feet. But now Stamboli right back up on top of Raven. Now Raven into the corner. Oh. And you can hear the impact. And Stamboli apparently has found another gear.
Oh, it's the top.
New clothesline on the top. Could this be enough in the middle?
Dan Boley can't believe it. He thought he put him away with that. He thought he saw the victory away, but didn't get it done.
I thought he put him away with
that. I did too.
Well, now, Raven, wait a second. These two guys played a little do-si-do.
Oh, tilt-a-whirl slam.
Huge tilt-a-whirl slam, but not nearly enough that time. And Stan Bowley, he certainly could use a victory over the over a superstar the caliber of Raven as well to help his career.
Without a doubt, Stan Bowley needs his victory. This would be a huge feather in his cap here in his career in the WWE.
And now Raven off the ropes.
Oh! Hit us with DDT! Unbelievable!
He catches Stan Bowley midair and forget about it.
Here is your winner, Raven!
Big win for Raven. Impressive. Well, you know, D, I'll give it to Raven.